Do you know what Google Search, Alexa, Facebook, and Donald Trump have in common? Follow me in this episode and lead tutorial and I will tell you. Hi, today we're going to talk about natural language processing, or NLP. NLP is a technique in computer science that teaches the computer how to understand text. For example, Google uses it to match query to documents, and Alexa uses it to transform our voice into commands, and Facebook uses it to detect spammy comments, and also politicians actually use it to detect the topic of interest of their voters. Let's try to understand what is natural language processing. In linguistics, natural language is a language that has evolved in humans through repeating use without any planning. According to statistics, the most popular natural language in the world by their speakers are English with 1.39 billion or 1,390 million speakers, Mandarin Chinese with 1.15 billion speakers, Spanish with 661 million speakers, Hindi with 544 million speakers, and Arabic with 422 million speakers. There are 6,500 of different natural languages in the world. On the other hand, when we have natural languages, of course, we expect to have artificial languages as well. All programming languages such as Python, JavaScript, PHP, HTML, XML are all artificial languages and used by computers and machines to exchange information. But we also have artificial languages like Esperanto and Klingon are designed for human communication. And currently, we have more than 1,000 of different artificial languages in the world. Now that we understand what is natural language, let's take a look at the processing. Generally, there are 5 steps in natural language processing, which are tokenization, stop word remover, stemming, lemmatization, and also part of speech tagging. Let's take a look at tokenization first. In most languages like English, we can use the space as the separator and break the sentence into meaningful units called tokens. And we remove punctuations like comma, colon, full stop along the way as well. And this will give us 6 tokens. We can use the same methods for other languages as long as they use space as the separator between each words. It only becomes more challenging and requires extra work when we are dealing with languages that don't use space as a separator. For example, Chinese, Japanese, and Thai language. After we understand the purpose and how tokenization works, the next step that we need to do is to remove stop words. Stop words in a language are words that are commonly used but don't help us much in understanding the content. For example, the, below, am, yours. So in our example, the stop words here are is and If we remove them from the sentence, although it violates the grammar, it doesn't affect us much in understanding the meaning of the sentence or at least gather the context. Stop word remover is the process to remove words that are frequently appearing in a language and they don't help the computers to gather context. And also, by doing so, we can reduce the computation time required. And next up, we are going to perform stemming. Stemming is a process that helps us to normalize word variations back to their root form. For example, today, if we were to process an article about internet connections, some of the words in the article would be like connects, connected, connecting, connections, or even connections. Without any processing, computers will consider them as 6 different unit terms. But in fact, they refer to the same word, but they just appear in different tenses and forms. In order to have an accurate calculations, all the suffixes should be stemmed and convert to its basic root form. This is basically how the stemming process works. A question you might have now is, what about those word variations that do not have a suffix? For example, began, begun, drank, drunk, flew, flown, and rats, mouse, and mice. We will need a more advanced technique which is called lemmatization that help us to overcome this problem. We use lemmatization to process words that cannot be normalized by stemming, and we further reduce words of similar concepts to a common root form using dictionary or any other external knowledge. The last bit of the natural language processing is part of speech tagging. Part of speech tagging helps us to further identify the category of the word, to understand its role and relationships so that we can compare it with other terms. It can detect noun, verb, determiner, or in a more complex situations, it can also detect other parts of speech like prepositions and pronouns. Now that you understand what are the processes in NLP, let's look at how we can apply them in our business. In the case of product reviews, we can use NLP to extract sentiments keywords from a customer's comment and feedback. And then from there, we can learn about how the customer feels about their purchases. We can also use NLP to analyze tweets to learn about the topics that people are discussing. For example, how the public feel about the chickens between KFC and McDonald's. In fact, politicians also use a similar approach to try to understand the topics that their voters care. By now, you should have a clear understanding about NLP and how it can be applied in different data science tasks to answer business questions. Let me know if you have any questions in the comment section, and I will see you in the next tutorial.